issues, but, you know, my take on it is the Republicans have been like, okay, show up, vote, then sit down and shut up, and, oh, yeah, we'll get to yours, we'll get to your concerns, but not this election. Just wait a second, not this. We got to do this. I'm tired of it. If not now, when? I'm tired of being taken advantage of, and I'm tired of these people making war on us and then counting on us to show up and vote for them every time. They do stuff like this. They make war on us. They've got to pay for it. It's got to cost something. And if that means they don't get the Senate, oh well.
And that's and that's the risk that has to be considered with that. Pete, I appreciate the call in. See, you know, and I don't. There's been times before that I have, you know, when people was like, "Oh, I'm not going to vote for this person. I didn't like him." I'm going. I think that you know you can't use that universal statement with everything. But this is a vastly different exception, in that you actually had people trying to impugn the characters of grassroots in the same way that progressives do. And they're supposed to be on our side. And I just cannot believe that they feel that is acceptable. And the thing that stuns me the most is that race, I mean, it's not like Childers is ever going to have a shot in Hades at winning it. Come on. They could have gone with McDaniel and have been fine. It's not about what's best for the party to those people. It's about what's best for the people making money off that candidate. That's what it's about for them. You know, they tried to do the same thing with Ben Sasse in Nebraska. They tried to do the same thing with him. And he ended up stomping the candidate that the National Republican Senatorial Committee got behind. And then they had to go back and try to make nice with him. That didn't even have to happen. It's this insistence that they want their guys because they have their little, they have their crew together, their establishment clique. And yes, it that's exactly what it is. A party is only going to be as healthy and as as healthy and relevant as the members of that party. And they refuse to allow, in a lot of these areas, they refuse to allow to even consider new blood, keeping people in for 40, 50 years in a seat who don't do anything for the electorate. When's the last time Thad Cochran championed anything except for TARP? Seriously. But I don't want, and I said this earlier, I don't want people to look at Mississippi and think that this is in any way. Some folks in the Republican Party want you to think that this is, oh, well, you know, look, we beat you back here. Sorry, dudes, we took out your number two guy in the House. Grassroots did that in Virginia. I was in Virginia a couple times talking to folks there, and that was all grassroots. That was all grassroots that did that. They were fed up with Eric Cantor. They made that happen for themselves. It's what's going to have to happen in Mississippi. And they're going to have to do it in the numbers that will overtake any kind of fraudulent race baiting anything. When we come back, we got a little bit of hate mail as well. Don't go anywhere. We're trying to get everything in. Keep it here.
Listen here, baby. Let's stop acting so crazy.
This is The Dana Show.
I only want an itch and desire. Let me stand next to your fire.
Are open now at 866-455-9797. This is The Dana Show.
We have got to get into it. I have some delicious hate mail for you all, and I want to make sure that we get into each and every one of them. Let's go with that.
It's now that time of the week to open up Dana's big mailbag of hate.
Now, I did take this lady to the bank while filling in for Glenn just the other day because her name is Susie Madrick, and she's some sort of editor over at Crooks and Liars, which adamantly hates me. She looks like what were to happen if you combined Garth from Wayne's World, if you combined Jeff Bridges from Big Lebowski, Harry from Dumb and Dumber, And that one guy who talks of that blonde-headed guy, the bespectacled blonde-headed guy who talks about pop culture and et cetera and reviews movies, that dude, who else? Anyway, it looks if you mashed all those people together, it's Susie Madrick. So she immediately, this, like, she started in, this didn't even fall into my timeline until I happened to notice it one evening when I was doing some radio prep. I think my husband had tweeted something to the effect that he didn't want to be droned for illegally owning and peacefully owning a firearm. Legally owning is, you know, his own firearm. He didn't want to be droned. It was some sort of article that this woman had written. And I don't even think he addressed her, but apparently she monitors social media for mentions of her name. And so she went after him and immediately brought my children into it. Now, I always assume that when a progressive man or a progressive woman targets your children, I just assume that they're not man enough or woman enough, in Susie Madrick's case, to handle the adults there. So they go after the children. And so I told her she was a vulture and to leave my children alone, to which she responded. And again, we do dramatic readings of all of this because, frankly, it makes it far more entertaining for all of us. And this is how they talk, you know. So Susie Madrick tweeted to me, "My goodness, you are certainly facile with lies, your poor children." Again, bringing my children into it. And I told her she was a disgusting person because she will not stop using my children in a debate because she's not woman enough to step two. So she responds, "I'm disgusting because I point out that your children might want a dad who has honesty and integrity as values." No, you're disgusting because, in addition to looking like a female Garth from Wayne's World and Jeff Bridges from Big Lebowski, your character and your inability to hold on to any level of any semblance of morality makes you disgusting. Please go ahead and defend infanticide while using my children to talk about honesty and integrity. I thought, I had remarked online that I asked her if I needed to be concerned that an adult woman had a very inappropriate obsession with my two minor children. And if you don't want me to be concerned as a mother from any behavior that might strike me as a little perverted and or odd, then I suggest you keep my kids out of it. Moving on down the line. So we have, let's see. I don't even think I can read some of this stuff. I don't think I can read some of this stuff on air. Okay, so I had two dudes, one whose name was Joshua on Twitter, and another guy who thinks that he's anonymous and isn't because I've already doxed him, who goes by an anonymous name on Twitter, who for like 3 hours the other night fantasized about raping me, which I thought, you know, these are what progressive males do. And then at the same time, they get so angry at you when you want to be able to legally carry your firearm because men like this exist and talk about fetishizing raping you on Twitter. So I have screenshots of everything. I don't even think I can say, like, one of them said, like, they would link and tunnel me. What does that even mean, Kevin? Ideas?
No.
Do you
clue.
Know what that means?
No clue.
I don't know what that means either.
That is a new one for me. That is a new one.
I'm afraid to look that up.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can't even read some of, you know what? I am going to publish them, though. Over at danaradio.com, I'm going to publish each and every one of these in just a minute. And you'll be able to see them for yourself. Because I don't think, like, I'm pretty sure, like, any sort of slang for female genitalia in any kind of George Carlin-esque curse adjective that describes the act of fornication, probably not permissible to read on air. I'm just going to go out
and read it. You're correct. Church and I are both sitting over here like we're like the jury going, yes, 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 you're correct.
Okay, so see, look how I'm being really, yeah. I asked, didn't I?
When in doubt.
So people can go and read them. They can go to danaradio.com and read them because they are really bad, really, really bad. But now for all of the money that we're going to make off this, Kevin, I'm going to get some more Shiner Bock because I'm out of Shiner. I'm going to get me some Shiner, get the family reunion pack.
Yes, get the family reunion pack, a great one.
That's what that's actually called, too. They for real call it the family reunion pack. I'm going to get that and I'm going to go and I need to get, some, margarita mix. I'd like to get some strawberry margarita mix, right? I can get that, add that to it. You have to add it to it. It's not adding. You got to cha-ching it.
Oh, sorry. Here we go.
Hello.
I'll do it again. I'll do it a couple more
thank
times
you.
Here.
Yeah, thank you. And then I'm going to put a little extra in the plate for Jesus on Sunday. Can you go ahead and cha-ching that for me, too, please? Thank you, sir.